up, get up, get up, get up.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to FFW Genesis. I am your host, Christopher Billings, and ladies and gentlemen, if you missed the action last week, you definitely want to go back and check those out, both Genesis and Strike Zone from last week. It was also announced earlier today, ladies and gentlemen, Die Hard is in the arena tonight, and he has a match scheduled for later on this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, we're getting ready to kick this night off with some tag team action. We've got Bryson and Mark Lester getting ready to take on Alex McNabb and Randy Lynch. A very promising team, I believe. I think that they have all the tools that would be necessary, Alex McNabb and Randy Lynch, as well as Bryson and Mark Lester. So we're getting ready to get this matchup underway in just a few moments here. I'm looking forward to it. I hope you guys are ready. I'm ready to get this night underway. Like I said, if you missed last week, you need to definitely go check it out, ladies and gentlemen. It was definitely a good watch.
Weighing in at a combined weight of 470 pounds, Alex McNabb and Randy Lynch.
And as you see, McNabb and Lynch here coming to the ring. And, the camera makes Lynch and McNabb look like they're almost sizable with each other, but Lynch is an adrenaline weight class wrestler. Randy Lynch wrestles in the adrenaline weight class, but he's built, ladies and gentlemen, he is built like a heavyweight. He doesn't have enough body weight behind him to be considered a heavyweight, so he technically falls into the category of an adrenaline weight class wrestler, but he, like I said, he's built like a heavyweight. He doesn't have the height, but his build, always hitting the gym, always in the gym. He's extremely ripped to be such a small man. But their opponents tonight, Bryson and Mark Lester. Bryson and Mark Lester never had any problems, I don't think, hitting their growth spurts when they were younger, especially for Bryson. Bryson is clearly the largest man in this tag team match. But, McNabb and Lynch looking to make an impact here in the tag team division in FFW. As you see, McNabb and Lynch awaiting the arrival of Bryson and Mark Lester.
Weighing in at a combined weight of 517 pounds, Damage Incorporated.
And you heard the ring announcer, 517 pounds against, I think it was 419 pounds. Clearly, Bryson and Mark Lester have a 100-pound weight advantage over McNabb and Lynch. Now, is that going to be the deciding factor in this matchup? We're about to find out in just a few moments, ladies and gentlemen. Like I said, Bryson and Mark Lester, Mark Lester himself, 250-plus. Bryson, even bigger than that, ladies and gentlemen. As you see, both of these men very swelled up. Very larger-than-life athletes, ladies and gentlemen, here at FFW. We'll get ready to get this matchup underway here. Bryson, Mark Lester versus Alex McNabb and Randy Lynch. Some good old-fashioned tag team action to kick off the night. We're getting ready to get this matchup underway. Like I said, I'm expecting this to be a very exciting tag team match, to say the least, ladies and gentlemen. It looks like McNabb is going to start this here against Bryson. And up next, ladies and gentlemen, Gabriel Graves takes on Damian Wallace one-on-one. We pushed the match with James Anderson that Gabriel Graves would have had is not going to happen. As you see, Lester here, right from the get-go, going after McNabb's arm. Lester trying to make quick work of Alex McNabb here. That's clearly what he's trying to do, but McNabb responds with a sleeper hold. A basic sleeper hold, forcing the break is Mark Lester. Oh, and Mark Lester, big knee to the ribs. And now look at this, Mark Lester starting to fire at Alex McNabb. Lester, quick duck under there. Another duck under. And Lester catches McNabb, big backdrop. And ladies and gentlemen, make sure to follow FFW on Twitter, at FFWCall. Use the hashtag FFWrestling or FFWRevolution. As you see, Mark Lester now tagging in the tag team partner, Bryce, and tag team chemistry from Damage Incorporated. Big spear and clothesline there. Mark Lester hooking the far leg in the cover here. One, two, and almost a three count there in the very early goings of this matchup. And ooh, Bryce planting the knee right into McNabb's forehead. When you look at people like Bryson lunging head, but when you look at wrestlers like Bryson or Lester, you know, you can clearly see that they definitely have that size advantage over Alex McNabb and Randy Lynch. McNabb looks small and cumbersome compared to Bryson Mark Lester. As Bryson tangling up the legs here of Alex McNabb, as the referee is doing his count. And Randy Lynch has yet to get involved in this matchup. It looks like Mark Lester may have slipped up there a little bit. Oh, and a big right hand there from Alex McNabb. And up next, ladies and gentlemen, Gabriel Graves does take on Damian Wallace one-on-one. Just a friendly reminder there. And Randy Lynch did get tagged in, by the way. Randy Lynch is a legal man. It seems to be that there's some confusion of who the legal man is in this match. Bryson now catching Randy Lynch with that big spine buster. Just like that, Bryson and Mark Lester back in the driver's seat here. But Randy Lynch reverses. And the big snake eyes there in the corner. And Randy Lynch, a ferocious elbow, does not knock Bryson down. And Bryson, big DDT. And Bryson and Mark Lester thus far have been on their A game during this matchup, ladies and gentlemen. What is Bryson? Bryson might be trying to set something up here to put Randy Lynch away, but Randy Lynch firing back. Randy Lynch not taking the beating without fighting back here, but the strikes of Bryson. Like I said, Bryson, a big, big man. Very, very big man. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, on January 23rd, the FFW Breakdown Rumble match, and the Rumble itself will be live right here on YouTube and on Twitch. As you see, going into the corner there, and now Randy Lynch tagging McNabb in. McNabb, a kick right to the ribs, and a quick crucifix there from Alex McNabb on Bryson. McNabb sending. Oh, he pulls Bryson in with a big neck breaker. Looking the far leg here. One, two, and a two count as Bryson gets his shoulders off the mat. McNabb trying to dictate the pace of this matchup, trying to slow it down here, ladies and gentlemen. A series of elbows to the top of the skull. Now McNabb missed wildly there as Bryson got up in a quick roll up here from Bryson. You don't see that very often. One, two, and a two count as McNabb able to kick out. Wait a second, Bryson caught McNabb and slams him down. And that might be it, ladies and gentlemen. The Bryson bottom there, that's got to be it. Hooking the far leg here. One, two. And a two count as McNabb again able to get his shoulders off the mat. And now Bryson tagging in Mark Lester. And Mark Lester, big knee to the side of the skull of of Alex McNabb there. McNabb getting back to his feet. Owen McNabb went to go after Bryson. I don't think McNabb realized that Bryson was no longer the legal man. Now McNabb here trying to set this up. A big move. Oh, no. And Mark Lester countered there with a big snapmare. Followed up by a big spinal tap. McNabb now into the cover, hooking the leg here. Lester. A two count on McNabb. Now Lester torquing the side of the head and the neck of Alex McNabb, ladies and gentlemen. And oh, McNabb, big counter. Plants Lester and edges on McNabb, hit one knee there. McNabb with that knee right to the ribs. Catches Lester with a standing side effect there. And again, McNabb hits one knee. And McNabb tagging in Randy Lynch. Randy Lynch definitely the freshman in this matchup. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, up next, Gabriel Graves takes on Damian Wallace. One-on-one, and that will happen in just a few moments here. As Randy Lynch now sending Lester into the corner. And the referee got right in the way and got knocked down there. Ooh, and a kick right to the ribs from Randy Lynch. Oh, but Mark Lester, big shoulder tackle. It's like every time Randy Lynch or McNabb get a little bit of momentum, all of a sudden Mark Lester or Bryson are able to turn it back around. As you see, though, Randy Lynch showing no signs of quit here, ladies and gentlemen. Wait a second, look at this. Bryson grabbed Randy Lynch's arms as he was getting ready to strike. Which allowed Mark Lester to get back on the advantageous here. Lester might be looking to set something up. Wait a second, Lester pulls! Oh, and that big elbow that he just rocked. Randy Lynch into the cover here. One, two, almost a three count, but McNabb broke up the pin there. Oh, and a big left hand there. Wait a second. Randy Lynch going to plant Mark Lester face first after that punch to the side of the head. Lynch into the cover here. One, two, and only a two count as Mark Lester able to get his shoulders off the mat again. Wait a second. Randy Lynch. And, oh, big suplex throw there to the big man, Mark Lester. Randy Lynch calling Lester to his feet. Randy Lynch here. That rotating suplex. The referee catching McNabb on his way in there. As Lynch has the cover here. He definitely has a three count. One, two, and the three count there. Ladies and gentlemen, congratulations goes out to Alex McNabb and Randy Lynch. Hard-fought victory for them. I definitely thought that Mark Lester and Bryson may have had their number tonight, but that was not the case to be, ladies and gentlemen. So, unfortunately for Bryson and Mark Lester, they were not able to pick up the win. But with that being said, we're getting ready to move on further with this night again. Congratulations goes out to Alex McNabb and Randy Lynch for Damage Incorporated. They're going to have to go back to the drawing board and figure out what they can do perform better the next time they're in a tag team environment. As you see, Randy Lynch and Alex McNabb both celebrating in the ring here, celebrating their victory. I'm being notified that backstage we have Elizabeth Sims standing by with Steve Baker. Apparently Steve Baker has some sort of announcement to make, so we're going to go ahead And we're going to cut backstage to Elizabeth and see what she has to say, or what Steve Baker has to say to the FFW universe, to her, to all of us. And then we'll be getting the Gabriel Graves and Damian Wallace matchup underway. So we're going to cut backstage to Elizabeth Sims, and we'll see what Steve Baker has to say.
Mr. Baker, it was announced that Diehard has a match tonight. Any insight into that? Last time we saw Diehard compete, the arena went black, and Diehard was disqualified from his match?
It's funny you say that, because I could have sworn that when the arena lights went out, I saw Diehard grabbing a steel chair from under the ring. As for tonight, though, Diehard's current Rumble spot is number 26. And if it is up for grabs, as Diehard has to, and it is up for grabs, as Diehard has to defeat Darren Trinidad to maintain that spot. Now, if Darren Trinidad wins, then guess what? Diehard's new entry number will be number one in the Breakdown Rumble.
A huge, huge announcement there from Steve Baker regarding Diehard's match tonight against Darren Trinidad. We're getting ready to get Gabriel Graves versus Damian Wallace underway. And Gabriel Graves making his way to the ring tonight from New Jersey. And for Gabriel Graves, you know, this is his technical debut on Genesis. And, you know, we thought we were going to see him before. There was some weather-related delays, and so he wasn't able to have his debut against James Anderson. And that matchup has since been, from what I understand, has since been rescheduled for a later date. You know, whether it happens or not, I don't know. But we get ready to get Gabriel Graves and Damian Wallace underway here. And for Gabriel Graves, like I said, this is the first time, his first professional, or not his first professional match, but his first time in FFW being seen by the FFW universe. And the fans are very receptive to him thus far, which is always a good sign for a wrestler as they're coming into the business. So we're getting ready to get, like I said, we're getting ready to get this matchup underway. His opponent tonight, Damian Wallace, although clearly the smaller man in the match, not to be underestimated.
Weighing in at 218 pounds from Atlanta, Georgia, representing Heresy, Damian Wallace.
And as you heard, 218 pounds is Damian Wallace. And he's clearly smaller than Gabriel Graves. However, like I said, you cannot underestimate the tenacity of Damian Wallace. He's one of the most aggressive people that I've ever seen. He's like a rabid Wolverine. I don't want to say rabid Wolverine, but he's a rabid, rabid small man, ladies and gentlemen. He definitely knows what it takes to push the limits. And I've seen it before. Throughout my tenor, calling matches, I've seen Damian Wallace do some spectacular things in matches. So if he can make that happen tonight against Gabriel Graves, Damian Wallace may end up getting his hand raised by the end of the night. But we're about to get this matchup underway, the debut of Gabriel Graves against Damian Wallace. And this is going to set the tempo for Graves' career here in FFW. Here we go. And a standing tie-up. As Wallace, with the side headlock here, Wallace getting the better of the situation, but Graves backing Wallace into the ropes. A quick duck under there. Oh, and a jumping kick there from Damian Wallace, and a big back elbow there from Graves. And now look at this, Graves diving uppercut from the second rope, from the middle rope. Graves into the cover here. One, and only a one count as Damian Wallace quickly got his shoulders off the mat. And Wallace there, big counter. Followed up by a big back chop. Big, big back chop, ladies and gentlemen. Into the cover here, one, two, and a two count as Graves able to get his shoulders off the mat, but and as you saw the big elbow there from Graves, and Graves kicking Wallace out of the ring. Graves practicing going to the second rope there as Wallace now getting back to his feet. And Graves jumps up. Flying punch to the face of Damian Wallace, ladies and gentlemen. And Graves is still in control. The inexperienced Gabriel Graves still in control of Damian Wallace. What is Graves thinking here? Graves, Springboard throws his elbow right on the top of the skull, hooking the far leg here. One, two, and a two count as Damian Wallace again gets his shoulders off the mat. And Graves a standing clothesline there. Damian Wallace a quick hip toss, and that's what I say. You can't underestimate Damian Wallace. He is he's very versed and gifted in this business. And now look at this backbreaker to Gabriel Graves, picking up the bigger man here and stretching him across his knee. As you see here, Wallace ran in with a big knee, hooking the far leg here. One, but a one count as Graves able to get his shoulders off the mat. Of back and forth thus far in the match, followed up by that big back chop there from Damian Wallace. And a seated DDT there from Damian Wallace on Graves. And then a big reversal there from Gabriel Graves, sending Wallace into the ropes, pulls Wallace back into a big knee strike. And he has, Wallace a knee to the top of the head. Standing super kick from Wallace there. That's got to be it, hooking the far leg here. This has got to be it. One, and only a one count as Graves able to forcefully get his shoulder off the mat. And, Graves caught Wallace there with something unique that I don't know what that was, ladies and gentlemen. Now look at this. A double underhook suplex from Gabriel Graves. Wallace again turning the tide here. Like I said, Wallace is clearly the more experienced wrestler in this matchup, at least in the sense of being on a majorly broadcasted show, but I cannot take away from the tenacity of the young Gabriel Graves, and a kick to the ribs there from Wallace and a big drop kick to the side of the head. Now Wallace into the cover here. One, two, and another two count for Damian Wallace on Gabriel Graves. Graves turning it around here and kicking the chest of Damian Wallace. Now what is Graves thinking? Graves here setting up a basic neck breaker, nothing fancy about that, just a basic neck breaker, and that'll put you into the mat, ladies and gentlemen. And Graves missed with that big knee, but still able to turn it around and capitalize on the situation with a basic hanging suplex, nothing fancy. Again, just a maneuver to put Damian Wallace onto the mat. And now Graves sending Wallace to the outside. Wallace starting to get to his feet. Graves here jumps, big front flip. Over the top rope there to the outside. And then, ooh, a big neck breaker. And this matchup might be, I honestly think that Gabriel Gray should have went for the cover there, ladies and gentlemen. I think that this might have been it. That might have been it. I mean, clearly it looks like Damian Wallace might be out on his feet here. And a catching power bomb there from Gabriel Graves, hooking the far leg here in the cover. One, two, and a two count as Wallace able to kick out. Oh, but Wallace not backing down. Damian Wallace not backing down, and Gabriel Graves got to figure out a way to put Damian Wallace away. Wallace with a pullback neck breaker there. Graves trying to get back to his feet. Oh, and a big flying forearm. And Graves caught him with a tossing scoop slam. Oh, and a kick right to the ribs. Wallace went for another kick there, but was unsuccessful in that attempt, as Gabriel Graves still has all the momentum in his favor thus far. Now Gabriel Graves with the Fujiwara armbar. Again, Graves into the Fujiwara, working on the arm of Damian Wallace, just wrenching away on it, on that left arm. Now look at this, Gabriel Graves gonna eat the boot of Damian Wallace. Damian Wallace here telling the fans in attendance that he's got this matchup under control. Gabriel Graves standing drop kick. And now Graves from the ground with a basic suplex. And Graves might be setting something up. Graves catches Wallace there, hooking the far leg. One, two, and the three count. And Gabriel Graves' impressive debut victory here on Genesis against Damian Wallace. Just some basic refinements is what Gabriel Graves needs. And I'm sure that he will become a spectacular superstar here in FFW, ladies and gentlemen. Again, congratulations goes out to Gabriel Graves. Damian Wallace put up one heck of a good fight. Unfortunately, though, that fight just was not enough. Gabriel Graves was just too much for Damian Wallace to take out or take tonight. And so, again, congratulations goes out to Gabriel Graves. Very big congratulations. As Gabriel Graves is celebrating in the ring, ladies and gentlemen. Again, congratulations, Gabriel Graves. Damian Wallace, better luck next time, ladies and gentlemen. Or for Damian Wallace. And Gabriel Graves still taunting in the arena here as we get ready to cut to our first break of the night. And wait a second, what the hell? That's James Anderson. And he had a steel chair there right to the small of the back. What the hell just happened? James Anderson just attacked Gabriel Graves. Ladies and gentlemen, we have to take our first commercial break of the night. We will be back in just a few moments.
What defines a legacy? Defiance? I'm one of the most defiant men in this business. Rage? I'm one of the most vicious wrestlers to ever lace up a pair of boots.
Obstacles?
There isn't a thing in this business that I can't achieve on my own. Tenacity? I fight until there's nothing left to give. Revolution? I'm the man that started it for everyone.
And we're back here, folks, and we're getting ready to get this matchup underway. We've got Calvin Carter getting ready to take on Travis Porter, ladies and gentlemen. As we're waiting the arrival of Calvin Carter III.
Weighing in at 222 pounds from Hollywood, California, Calvin Carter III!
You gotta believe that Calvin Carter is trying to set his sights on possibly facing Tak Muri at FFW Breakdown for the Adrenaline Championship, as is probably Travis Porter. And Calvin Carter, very arrogant, very, very arrogant and pompous young man. However, I believe that Calvin Carter has all the tools that any one wrestler, especially in the adrenaline weight class, he's got the tools that any one wrestler would ever need to achieve his goals and to make what he wants to happen. It's just a matter of putting that into action. And so for Calvin Carter, you know, Travis Porter tonight, another test of will, so to speak, for Calvin Carter. And I spoke with Calvin Carter earlier today, and he said he's not sweating facing Travis Porter tonight. He doesn't seem to sweat too many people here in FFW in the Adrenaline Division. But at one point, Calvin Carter is going to face somebody in the Adrenaline Division that is either going to beat him or, you know, definitely make him realize that you can't just assume that, you know, other wrestlers aren't of the same importance. And this man, Travis Porter,
weighing in at 213 pounds, from Venice Beach, California, Travis Porter!
Like I was saying, for this man, Travis Porter, he's had such a long tenure here in FFW and TPP, within the TPP 2K umbrella, that honestly, you can't pass the buck over on Travis Porter. And speaking of TPP 2K, ladies and gentlemen, if you aren't aware by now, I'm going to let you be aware right now. TPP 2K is not just FFW. It is also the Professional or Pro Wrestling Alliance, PWA for short, which they just put out their debut episode last Friday or last Saturday afternoon, I believe. And I had the pleasure of being involved with that, and I think it's great that it's under the TPP 2K umbrella. We're getting ready to get this matchup underway. Travis Porter versus Calvin Carter. I was told, though, by management that FFW wrestlers will not be performing on PWA and vice versa, at least for the foreseeable future, based on contracts. So we're getting ready to get this matchup underway, standing tie up here as Porter gets the better of the situation. And now look at this standing hammer lock here. But Carter able to switch it around into a hammer lock of his own. And this is thus far very slow in this matchup. And as you see, Porter turns it around into a hammer lock of his own. And wrenching away there. Now another big standing tie up. But now this time, wait a second. Porter backing Carter into the ropes, sending him into the ropes. Oh, and a standing drop kick there from Calvin Carter. Another standing drop kick. I thought this was going to be a more slow a slow-paced technical match. However, that was not Calvin Carter's plan. Now, Calvin Carter, a small package roll-up here. One, and a one count as Porter able to kick out. Oh, and a kick right to the thigh there, but Travis Porter responds a big forearm strike. Look at this, and the forearms are flying between Calvin Carter and Travis Porter, but Carter responds with a punch right between the eyes there. And now Calvin Carter with a bridging suplex with the bridge on it, and he went for the cover there in a long one count as Porter able to kick out. Travis Porter trying to get back to his feet here. Wait a second, Calvin Carter, quick German suplex, and with the bridge on that, one, only another one count there. Now Calvin Carter, snap suplex, going for the cover here. One, two, and Travis Porter again resiliently getting his shoulders off the mat. As you saw, Carter got in the face of the referee, but the referee got out of the way there. As Travis Porter striking back here. Travis Porter might be looking for something here. He's going to hot shot on the shoulders and then up to the outside, ladies and gentlemen. Porter's going to jump in. Big missile drop kick there, taking Calvin Carter down, hooking the far leg. One, two, and a two count for Travis Porter. Porter springboards into that body press. Again, going for the cover here. One, two, and another two count, and Travis Porter going, how did he kick out of that? I mean, that was very quick impact on part of Travis Porter. And Travis Porter again responds with those strikes, followed up by a big DDT. Oh, and Travis Porter, a double foot stomp. Oh, and a kick right to the chin. Not going to do Calvin Carter any favors. And now Porter going high risk here, ladies and gentlemen. Porter jumps up, misses with that big frog splash. He extended his chest and hit the mat. This is going to allow Carter here to capitalize on the situation, tying up the legs here. He's got the leg of Travis Porter. And now a figure four here right up against the ring post, wrenching on the... on the leg, Travis Porter, not known to have strong legs, and Calvin Carter utilizing that effect there. And Carter runs in, big standing drop kick, as the referee continues his count here. And now Carter going to stomp on the inside of the knee. Wait a second, Calvin. Carter going to... I'd snap that leg back and forth. And Carter got in the ring to break the count, and now the referee's count does restart as Travis Porter trying to get back to his feet. He's holding his left knee. Clearly his knee is damaged now, ladies and gentlemen. Look at this, Calvin Carter, insult to injury, tying up that knee again in a seated figure four. And still though, Travis Porter trying to hang in here. And Porter was back to his feet and responds with a series of strikes here to Calvin Carter. And Porter's going to try to maybe turn this matchup around here. Porter now ascending the top rope. That's a long ways to jump. Porter jumps up, big flying elbow drop. Last ditch effort there from Travis Porter, hooking the far leg here. One, two, and a two count as Carter able to kick out. Wait a second, Calvin Carter now. Again, that bridging suplex, this time without the bridge. Oh, and Calvin Carter now, stomping on that damaged leg of Travis Porter. just picking apart the limbs. And Calvin Carter showing aggression here. Look at this. Look at Calvin Carter working that left knee in the ropes. And Travis Porter's knee has got to be hurting three different ways from Sunday, ladies and gentlemen, as Porter getting back to his feet here. And, oh, Travis Porter going off the ropes out of nowhere with that hot shot leg drop bulldog. Hooking the far leg. This might be it. That was out of nowhere. One, two, and a two count. And Porter can't believe it. Calvin Carter was able to get his shoulders up, and Carter now catches the knee there. And Travis Porter, he is wrenching, ladies and gentlemen. And Porter has nowhere to go. He can't reach the ropes here. He's either got to tap or else he's got to get out of this submission hold. And as you see, Porter could not take any more. Calvin Carter picks up the win after wrenching that knee on the outside of the ring area. Congratulations goes out to Calvin Carter, picking up a one-sided victory almost. I mean, Travis Porter just could not get out of the gates, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, got to give credit where credit is due for Travis Porter. He tried, ladies and gentlemen, but Calvin Carter was just too much for Travis Porter to take tonight on Genesis, as Calvin Carter now celebrating in the ring. Also being notified that Elizabeth Sims is standing by backstage with Anthony Guerrero Jr. Hopefully to get a few words with Anthony Guerrero Jr. about his upcoming tag team title defense that was made official. He's got a title defense on Thursday on Strike Zone. But again, congratulations goes out to Calvin Carter. I would say a hard-fought victory, but it looked like Calvin Carter was in pretty firm control of that matchup, ladies and gentlemen. So we're going to cut backstage here in a few moments and see what Anthony Guerrero Jr. has to say to Elizabeth Sims. Like I said, hopefully we can get some comments regarding his upcoming tag team title defense. So let's cut backstage to Elizabeth.
Anthony, your former tag team partner, your uncle, James Braden, retired from the wrestling business back in November. Last week, you defended the FFW Tag Team Championships in a handicap match against the Haynes Brothers. You have another scheduled title defense Thursday night on Strike Zone. Again, against the Haynes Brothers. Who is your partner?
I'm not gonna lie, I don't have a partner. But I was raised in a family that lived for wrestling. To this day, my father still laces up his boots. Heck, he's gonna do that later tonight. As for how I will continue on without a partner, well, it's in the Guerrero bloodline to be able to do things that most can't. So I guess I'm gonna have to walk this path alone and defend these tag team titles by myself.
Solid words from Anthony Guerrero Jr., one half of the tag team champions. I guess, theoretically, he's the tag team champions because he doesn't have a tag team partner right now, but we're getting ready to get the co-main event of the
evening
underway.
Weighing in at 236 pounds from Indianapolis, Indiana, Riley Thompson.
As you heard, Riley Thompson, like I said, this is the co-main event of the evening, Riley Thompson versus Lance Owens. So we're getting ready to get this matchup underway. This is going to be an interesting matchup, to say the least. Lance Owens still celebrating his victory, winning the FFW Internet Championship, a hard-fought victory for Lance Owens. Undoubtedly, there's no doubt in my mind about that, ladies and gentlemen. But Riley Thompson has got to be looking for... he's going to be looking to make an impact against the Internet Champion. This way he could maybe in the future get to compete against Lance Owens or whoever the Internet Champion is at Breakdown or after Breakdown, somewhere within that juncture, within that area. As Riley Thompson, getting himself psyched up to compete against the Internet Champion. Like I said, Lance Owens very celebratory when it comes to his championship win, which he won against Rollin Ryder back at FFW Endgame. As Lance Owens get ready to come to the ring here.
Weighing in at 241 pounds from Fairbury, Nebraska, he is the FFW Internet Champion, Lance Owens!
Fairbury, Nebraska's very own Lance Owens getting amazing support from the FFW fans. And you know, for Lance Owens, it was years coming. You know, he was finally given that big opportunity, and he was able to showcase his skills against Roland Ryder at FFW Endgame and pick up the win and be able to say that he is now the FFW Internet Champion again. Hard-fought victory for Lance Owens, undoubtedly. And the fans showing their support. For many years, Lance Owens has had the support of the FFW universe. He couldn't get matches. He couldn't win matches, ladies and gentlemen. That's just the way it is. Lance Owens was not winning matches. But that's not the case anymore, as clearly Lance Owens won a big one, for him at least. I guess for Lance Owens, his next step may be the FFW Championship, maybe somewhere down the line. But we're getting ready to get this underway. Riley Thompson, Lance Owens, one-on-one, non-title. And here we go. Owens and Riley Thompson, a big right hand, a big slap there. But Lance Owens with a side headlock. Riley Thompson sending Owens into the ropes. And as you saw, Lance Owens caught himself there. Riley Thompson starting to already dictate the pace of this match. Grabbing the hair of Lance Owens across the knee. Now, what is Thompson thinking? Thompson has Owens up on his shoulder and drops him right on the top turnbuckle there. Wait a second, Lance Owens caught the leg in a big dragon screw. And Lance Owens has got to try to turn this around. Lance Owens, a basic drop toe hold, nothing fancy. Oh, and Riley Thompson, big counter from the ground. They're standing drop kick. And for Riley Thompson, very impressive to do that standing drop kick. Riley Thompson, for those of you that don't know, stands at 6'6". He has a very unique build compared to most wrestlers. He's tall and he's skinny, ladies and gentlemen. He only weighs, I want to say, about 230 some odd pounds, so he's not that big. But Riley Thompson Lance Owens counters, I'm sorry about that. But like I said, Riley Thompson, a very unique build when it comes to other wrestlers that I've seen in this business. I mean, you compare him to Lance Owens and Owens with the Northern Lights Bridge here. Two and a two count. But like I said, you compare Riley Thompson with Lance Owens, and Lance Owens looks jacked compared to Riley Thompson, and it's just it's a matter of size, the sizing of them. They're very close in weight, but clearly Riley Thompson built almost like his father. His father, Brandon Thompson, though, much more husky. He's more similar to Lance Owens. As you see Lance Owens here taunting to the FFW fans, Riley Thompson has not packed on all the muscle that his father had, but you know, he's still relatively young in his career, the tender age of 25. Oh, and a kick right to the shoulder blades there of Riley Thompson. And for Riley Thompson, I believe he is the second or third oldest man here, or youngest man in FFW. Anthony Jr. just a year younger than Riley Thompson, and a big spinal tap there from Riley Thompson. Now Thompson sending Owens to the corner in the hard way there. And although Riley Thompson is not built super big, he is strong, ladies and gentlemen. It's not to be confused. His build is not explanatory of how strong he is, but a kick to the side of the head, that'll seat anybody, ladies and gentlemen. As you see, again, Lance Owens taunting. And Riley Thompson, a big right hand, and then a big uppercut. And Owens now, a big pullback neck breaker. Owens into the cover here. One, only a one count, as Riley Thompson able to get his shoulders off the mat. Kick to the small of the back, but that time Riley getting back to his feet, big shoulder tackle. And now, ooh, kick right to the spine. is Riley Thompson thinking about doing here? Riley Thompson lifting Lance Owens up and clubs him across the back. Thompson is trying to soften the back. You gotta believe he's looking for that stargazer, the dream streak. Now Thompson, oh, wait a second, Owens counters. Oh, big running clothesline there. I gotta hand it to Lance Owens, ladies and gentlemen. Owens is doing great. Oh, there's one elbow, a second elbow, a third elbow. The fans are counting as Lance Owens is hitting these continuing elbow drops here. And Owens, I'm getting dizzy doing this, ladies and gentlemen. Owens slicking back the hair, a final jumping elbow drop there. Wait a second, Lance Owens. Waiting for Riley Thompson. Thompson pulling himself back to his feet. Owens standing sidekick there. That might be it, ladies and gentlemen. Hooking the far leg. One, two, and a two count as Riley Thompson able to get his shoulders off the mat. Then, Riley Thompson responding with a big elbow, followed up by a series of strikes. And now Riley Thompson. He's got Owens up in a big alley-oop there. And that'll definitely change the pacing and the makeup of the match. Now Riley Thompson sending Owens to the outside. As you see now, Riley Thompson getting too full of himself. Lance Owens getting back into the ring here. Runs in, and they miss Wildy with that knee there. Now Riley Thompson able to capitalize on this in that seated DDT. I think Riley Thompson may have goaded Lance Owens into making that mistake, thinking that Thompson was not paying attention, ladies and gentlemen. Now Thompson stomping on the elbow. Thompson sending Owens back in the corner, but Owens counters, but Thompson counters there. Wait a second, Thompson, the dream streak, that's gotta be it. Thompson hooking the far leg here. One, two, and a two count is somehow, some way, Lance Owens kicks out. Wait a second, Owens trying to get back to his feet. And Owens flies in, big forearm there. Another big forearm. And now that half Nelson face buster. And Lance Owens, a second win here. Just bringing everything he can to the table. Now Lance Owens has Thompson up, and he slams him over. Wait a second, Owens is calling Thompson to his feet. Wait a second, Owens hooking the arms and plants him with the DDT. That's gotta be it, ladies and gentlemen. Owens hooking the far leg here. One, two, three, and that is all she wrote. Lance Owens picks up the win, ladies and gentlemen, and is able to continue his celebratory experience as being the FFW Internet Champion. Congratulations goes out to Lance Owens tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Riley Thompson put up one heck of a good fight, ladies and gentlemen. And up next, the main event of the evening, Diehard versus Darren Trinidad. I'm interested to see how that's all going to pan out, ladies and gentlemen. Again, congratulations goes out to Lance Owens. Definitely a hard-fought victory for Lance Owens tonight. And again, you can't take anything away from Riley Thompson. Riley Thompson came out there and gave it everything he could. Unfortunately, it just was not enough to stop the momentum of Lance Owens right now, as you see Lance Owens celebrating. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got to take our final commercial break of the night. We'll be back in just a few moments, ladies and gentlemen. Again, congratulations goes out to Lance Owens. A tough break for Riley Thompson. But ladies and gentlemen, we got to take our final commercial break of the night. We'll be back in just a few moments with the conclusion of this episode of Genesis. So sit tight, everyone, and we will be right back.
What defines a revolution? Is it the company you keep? Is it the matches that you win? Is it the way that you wrestle? Is it the championships that you hold? No. A revolution is defined by who you are.
And we're back here, folks, and it's main event time of the evening. This man, Darren Trinidad, getting ready to take on Die Hard. This would be the first time ever for Darren Trinidad to take on, you know, to take on Die Hard. I'm interested to see how this is all going to pan out, ladies and gentlemen. We're about to find out in just a few moments. Darren Trinidad making his way to the ring now, awaiting the arrival of Die Hard, ladies and gentlemen. And Trinidad currently has the number one Rumble spot.
Weighing in at 233 pounds from Chicago, Illinois, Darren Trinidad.
And like I said, Darren Trinidad right now has the number one Rumble entry spot. If he can pin Die Hard to the mat tonight, or make him submit, or win by countout, then we would see Darren Trinidad get Die Hard's entry spot at number 26. You know, for Die Hard, he's got a great Rumble entry spot at 26. So if he can capitalize on that, I think if Darren Trinidad can capitalize on this tonight, it would do Trinidad very good, and Die Hard would have to enter at number one. The one thing that Trinidad needs to keep in mind is that Die Hard is he's a veteran. Die Hard's been in this business, this wrestling business, for over 18 years. He's got years and years of experience when it comes to a high-stakes match like this. Very, very high-stakes match in the sense of how this matchup can happen and what could happen in this matchup. So Trinidad's got to be ready for anything tonight against Die Hard. Die Hard is, like I said, he's very experienced, well-versed in this business. So Trinidad's got to be willing to go above and beyond his normal expectations. He's got to be willing to do what it takes tonight to put Die Hard away. And that's a lot easier said than done, ladies and gentlemen, as Die Hard now getting ready to come to the ring. And, you know, high stakes all around.
Weighing in at 263 pounds from Grand Rapids, Michigan, Die Hard.
As you heard the ring announcer, 263 pounds is Die Hard. I remember years ago, Die Hard was barely 220, 25 pounds. You know, now Die Hard's packed on 40 plus pounds of muscle and aging, ladies and gentlemen. Die Hard, as every show progresses, Die Hard gets that much older, ladies and gentlemen. Die Hard, like I said, he's been in this business for years and years and years. His knees surgically repaired. His back has been repaired numerous times. His arms, he's broken his neck before. He's wrestled with a broken hand during the match. He broke his hand and still continued to wrestle. You know, so for Die Hard, this is his coup d'etat. You know, this could be his last run as performer. And so you gotta believe Darren wants to go out with a bang. You know, it's just a matter of how much of a bang can he go out with. And this is one way to do it. Could you imagine Die Hard winning the Breakdown Rumble, ladies and gentlemen? Getting a guaranteed title opportunity? Could you imagine another Die Hard reign as champion? How weird and strange that would be. The last time Die Hard held the championship was December 29th, 2011. So it's been over 5 years since Die Hard has held a championship around his waist. Over 5 years, ladies and gentlemen. He's getting ready to square off here with Darren Trinidad. the winner of this matchup, either Diehard maintains his number 26 entry or Trinidad will take over that 26 entry and Diehard will be entering number one in the Breakdown Rumble. And Diehard turning it around into a side headlock there. And one thing that Trinidad cannot afford to do, he cannot afford to underestimate Diehard. The same goes for Trinidad, though. Diehard cannot underestimate Darren Trinidad. But especially for Trinidad, because Diehard, like I said, he's a veteran in this business, a standing tie-up here up against the ropes. The referee's looking for a clean break. And, oh, Diehard, big slap there. And again, right back into the standing tie-up. And I don't think Diehard slapped Trinidad as a sign of disrespect. He's just saying, you're not going to get me because I'm the weary veteran here. Trinidad sending Diehard into the ropes. Oh, and Diehard, big clothesline there, knocking Trinidad down. And again, right back into the tie-up here. Diehard again sending Trinidad into the ropes. And now the referee asking for a break, and Trinidad that time slapping Diehard. A big standing dropkick there from Darren Trinidad. Oh, and Diehard kicks the kneecap. Again, Diehard very experienced when it comes to... Oh, big shoulder tackle there from Diehard. Like I said, Diehard very experienced, ladies and gentlemen. Hook in the far leg here, one. And a one count is Trinidad able to get his shoulders off the mat. Diehard now going off the ropes. Trinidad kicked out the kneecap. And that's one way to definitely stake your claim against Diehard here. Trinidad, a belly-to-back suplex. Nothing fancy, a basic belly-to-back. Trinidad gonna springboard, misses with a leg drop there. And Diehard trying to capitalize a lunging headbutt. But Trinidad counters the third one. And Diehard again turning it around. And oh, Trinidad, big clothesline. A series of reversals there between these two. Trinidad pinching the trapezoidus muscle of Diehard. Trinidad into the cover here, one, and Diehard forcefully got his shoulders off the mat. And look at this, this cranium crunch here. As you see, Trinidad firing on all cylinders tonight. I think Trinidad realizes just how high stakes this matchup is. A Diehard series of big strikes. And now Diehard, that big T-bone suplex. As you see, Diehard taunting in the ring as Trinidad rolls to the outside, and Diehard not giving chase here. As Trinidad now out here in front of my announce table, just pacing the ring. Trinidad going to the top rope here. Diehard keeping long distance from Trinidad. And you know, surprisingly, Diehard let Trinidad get into the ring very cleanly there. Normally you just see Diehard attack. Oh, Diehard with that snapping knee attack to the forehead. And now Diehard gonna plant the leg right on the mat there, Darren Trinidad. Oh, and Trinidad, big counter. Now Diehard, overhead belly to belly. Diehard hooking the far leg here, this might be it. One, two, and no, it's gonna take more than that to put Darren Trinidad down, ladies and gentlemen. And Diehard missed Wally with that kick. Trinidad misses. And then Diehard misses as Trinidad responds with another belly to back suplex. Trinidad, beautiful standing shooting star press there, hooking the far leg. That might be a driving all the wind out of Diehard's lungs, but not even a one count as Diehard able to get his shoulders up. The referee may have taken too long to get into position. A big double axe handle there from Darren Trinidad. And beautiful standing drop kick there. Look, and as you see, Diehard now rolls to the outside here. is and Trinidad giving the same courtesy to Diehard, allowing Diehard to reset himself back in the ring, but Trinidad responds with a basic scoop slam. And Diehard turns it around again, sending Trinidad into the... Oh no, he sent him onto the ring apron there. And wait a second, Diehard, a big overhead belly-to-belly suplex from the outside of the ring to the inside of the ring, ladies and gentlemen. As you see, Diehard starting to breathe a little bit heavier than he normally does. Diehard now sending Trinidad into the ropes. And wait a second, Trinidad counters with a big DDT. And a big standing dropkick there from Darren Trinidad. And at this juncture, Trinidad's got to be trying to think of a way to put Diehard away. Ooh, Diehard big back elbow, because the longer the match goes, I mean, sure, it's going to benefit Trinidad because of Trinidad's age being younger than Diehard, but Diehard, so much experience when it comes to long matches. Diehard, big spine buster, the vintage spine buster that Diehard does, hooking the far leg on Trinidad. One, two, almost a three count, but Trinidad barely got his shoulders off the mat there. And Diehard now grabbing the hair and smacking the back across that knee brace. What's Diehard thinking here? And wait a second, Diehard again grabbing the hair. Diehard sending Trinidad back into the ropes. And wait a second, Trinidad, a judo trip there. Trinidad calling Diehard back to his feet. And wait a second, Trinidad, ooh, and he hit that big DDT. Trinidad into the cover here, one, two, and a two count as Diehard able to get his shoulders off the mat. Again, high stakes, ladies and gentlemen, very, very high stakes. And we just lost our camera feed. And the arena is black, ladies and gentlemen. We've lost our live feed. I do apologize for this. We still have our audio feed, thank God. I'm not really sure what the hell's going on here. We're trying to get our live feed back. And wait a second, what the hell? The Haynes brothers and Steve Baker, we're at ringside here. Trinidad realizes what's going on, and I think Diehard has locked eyes with Drew Haynes. I think Diehard now realizes what's going on, ladies and gentlemen. What the hell? The Haynes brothers have surrounded the ring. Darren and Trey Haynes now on the apron. The Haynes brothers surrounding Trinidad and Diehard. And here we go. We're gonna right from the onset, the Haynes brothers attacking Diehard and Darren Trinidad here. Drew Haynes on Diehard in the corner. Look at this, just the Haynes brothers now doing work. Wait a second. Drew Haynes, that big curb stomp to Diehard. And Jesus, ladies and gentlemen, the Haynes brothers have demolished Diehard and Darren Trinidad. And wait a second. Look at Trey Haynes here setting Darren Trinidad up for something. And Drew Haynes gonna slam Diehard on his face. Now look at this. Emphatically kissing, ooh, Darren Trinidad, slamming the head onto the mat. And now Steve Baker coming to the ring. Ladies and gentlemen, we're out of time for tonight. I'm assuming this matchup was thrown out.